إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, today is a good Friday in the eyes of the Christians. They believe today Nabiullah Isa alayhi salam وضع على الصليب فقتل خلاصا للبشرية ثم قام من الأموات يوم الأحد. They believe that today Prophet Isa was placed on the cross and he was killed to cleanse humanity from their sins, and then he was placed inside a tomb, a grave, and then he rose on Sunday. That is why Sunday also in the eyes of the Christians is called Easter Sunday. The Christian religion is actually built on this concept. And I do not mean the message which Prophet Isa delivered. لا. نحن نعلم أن نبي الله عيسى بلغ قومه التوحيد. لكن أنا أشير, I'm talking about what they made out of it. The doctrine of crucifixion is really the Christian religion. Basically, you believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. You have a confirmation that you're in Jannah. تؤمن بهذا تدخل الجنة. لا تؤمن بهذا. If you do not believe in this, you are a dweller of the hellfire. هذه العقيدة. وحقيقة, in fact, they actually went out to the world, Christians, يعني missionaries, and they are delivering this. And they are extremely active, for your information. And they are extremely active in the Muslim world. Basically, they go and they convey this message. بيبلغوا هذه الرسالة, بس بيبلغوها بإيه؟ Some incentives. They build a hospital, they build a school, they sponsor yatama, and believe Jesus Christ died in the cross for your sins, no problem, let's do it. فهم, they are delivering this message. And it's very unfortunate that very few Muslims know, except those who reverted. Yani those who accepted Islam, especially who came from Christianity, they understand exactly what this doctrine of crucifixion is about. Very few Muslims, yeah, they believe that Isa alayhi salam did not die on the cross. As simple as that. But they don't understand the implications of this. The environment on which that creed is established. And that is where missionary non-Muslims, they find a fertile ground amongst Muslims who simply are willing to accept this. In return, they get something from the dunya. And you know, they are very active in Africa. They are very active, extremely active in Indonesia. They do that. What does the Quran say? What does the Quran say about the crucifixion? Do we have a say about this event? That is the question that we have. But before I provide the evidence from the Quran, I want my brothers and sisters to be extremely sensitive when they bring this subject up. Because you're going to find out from the evidence which I'm about to bring out to you from the Quran that basically this did not even happen. You're simply telling a Christian that your religion is baseless. Then if no crucifixion, no salvation, no Christianity, as simple as that. لو ما فيش صلب ما فيش نجاة ما فيش نصرانية. But when you tell them this, why also? Because a Christian from the get-go, from the Sunday school time, every single morning he's taught this. Jesus Christ died in the cross for your sins. Jesus Christ died in the cross for your sins. عيسى مات على الصليب قتل على الصليب من أجل خطاياك. هكذا. He doesn't even bring this into questioning. Yani I want to say is that the event of crucifixion for a normal average Christian is a historic fact. It is not a theology issue. It is not a theology option. It's not something that has to do with the religion. For him is history. Isa mat ala salib, period. And they were brought up to believe this. So, if you are to talk about this, brothers and sisters in Islam, we have to be extremely sensitive and considerate. But this does not mean you compromise. Because I'm going to share with you the text right now. No ground for compromise whatsoever. You can't. هذا أمر عقدي. العقيدة إخوة في ديننا ما فيهاش كلام. Even if you have the biggest turbans. Now your turbans is as huge as this. And you compromise the aqidah, the creed, امشي امشي, روح, get a life, امشي. على طول, لأن الأمور بينة, ظاهرة, العقيدة ظاهرة, بينة, our عقيدة, لا إله إلا الله, محمد رسول الله, is crystal clear. فبي نايس, be sensitive, when you bring it up. لأن برضو الكلام عن الدين, يعني إيه, requires sensitivity a little bit. Or remember that you're giving da'wah. Yani don't teach them that the position of Islam on the issue while you're angry and upset and so forth. طيب. ماذا يقول القرآن عن صلب المسيح? What does the Quran say regarding the alleged crucifixion? I have confidence now to say the alleged crucifixion of المسيح. في آيات كثيرة نذكر منها. Number one, قول الله تعالى ممتنا على نبيه عيسى إذ قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم أذكر نعمتي عليك إذ أيدتك بروح القدس تكلم الناس في المهد وكهلا. أو عيسى سورة المائدة الآية remember my favors, my bounties upon you. You will speak to people in the cradle and as an old man. الكهولة, كهلة, الكهل اللي هو الرجل اللي ايه ماسك عصايا وبزك وهو ماشي. We know that سيدنا عيسى في سورة مريم spoke in the cradle. قال إني, فأشارت إليه, قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبيا؟ قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا. She pointed at him, مريم عليه السلام. They said, how can we speak to someone who's in the cradle? He said, I'm the servant of Allah. فكلم الناس في المهد. نحن نعلم حتى النصارى يوافقوننا. We know and the Christians agree with this, that سيدنا عيسى رفع and his age, Prophet Isa عليه السلام was raised at the age of 30. فمتى يحدث الكلام في الكهولة؟ لابد من العودة. He must come back to become an old man in order to speak to people when he is old. The other, towards the end of this verse, وَإِذْ كَفَفْتُ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَنْكَ. I protected you from Bani Israel. Allah is telling him that. طيب, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given Isa protection, that means there is no way for Bani Israel that they have put him on the cross. If I tell you, كففت يا إخوة, كف, الكف, والله المثل الأعلى, الكف, you do like this. من الكف, كف, هذا والكف, كففت, protected you. فهو الله سبحانه وتعالى would say, I protected you, and yet he allowed بني إسرائيل to place a hand on him. وفي الآية الأخرى في سورة آل عمران, فلما أحس عيسى منهم الكفرة قال من أنصاري إلى الله, قال الآيات. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ومكروا ومكر الله. They plotted, يعني بني إسرائيل مكروا عشان إيه؟ To kill عيسى. They plotted to kill نبي الله عيسى عليه السلام. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala plotted. When you say I blooded and you blooded, so your blood must be the opposite of my blood, otherwise it wouldn't be a blood. If two people are blooding against one another, it must be the opposite, the contrary. They blooded to kill Isa and Allah blooded to save Isa. لابد من العكس تماما. You say Allah blooded and yet he delivered Isa to them, ما ينفع. هذه ثانية. الآية يعني اللي ملهاش حل. The verse that في محل الخلاف, سورة النساء chapter 4 verse 157. وقولهم إنا قتلنا المسيح عيسى ابن مريم رسول الله. And they say that we killed عيسى ابن مريم, the messenger of Allah. Here it is. وما قتلوه. أهو. هذا قول الله. They killed him not. وما صلبوه. أهو. They crucified him not. لا تجد أحد يا إخوة يتكلم بهذا إلا عالم الغيب والشهادة. إلا عالم الغيب والشهادة. Only the knower of the present and the future, the seen and the unseen, would speak like this. They killed him not. They crucified him not. And I will go back to this verse. We're going to need it in the future. فهذه عقيدتنا. This is our creed regarding. We actually tell the Christians that all of this is wrong. You're basically telling the Christians that your religion is baseless. لأن دينهم, their religion is based on that event. Oh, that is why the issue is very sensitive. The issue is extreme. But yet, we live in America. We live in the West amongst Christians. We yet have to deliver this to them. So we have to find a way to tell them that. But it must be kind and nice, I stress. طيب. By the way, we don't have a problem with some people killing a prophet. We believe that Bani Israel, they killed other prophets. It's not nice to do it, but we know in Bani Israel killed other prophets. Sayyidina Yahya, John the Baptist, the biblical name, his head was chopped off. Zakariya nushira bil minshar. Zakariya was sued like this. Why do we have an issue with Sayyidina Isa in particular? Why did we say no? No. No to Isa. He was not touched. Why, ya ikhwa? This is important. This is important. I'll mention three or four reasons if time allows. The first reason, and pay attention to this, ya ikhwa, if you want to understand your religion. Introducing or streamlining the concept of salvation into believing that someone was placed in the cross for your sins changed the rules of the game. What the rules of, what do you mean? From Adam until they came up with this, the rules for salvation is observing the commands. That you follow the commands. Salli, salli. Zakki, zakki. No adultery, no adultery. No riba, no riba. Observing the commands of Allah. Now the rule of the game has changed in the middle. It's like you start a soccer game. I mean, not football, not necessarily soccer. And then here is the rule, 1, 2, 3, and then the referee in the middle says, I came up with a new rule. And nobody spoke of this. يعني انظر وانا اقول لك, I'm telling you. يعني انا يعني خطبة الجمعة, if I am speaking to a Christian, I will speak from the gospel. I will bring evidence from the Old and New Testament that the rule of the game has been always observing the commands. بس انا بخاطب مسلم. I'm talking to you. اقول لك آية في سورة النساء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ليس بأمانيكم ولا أماني أهل الكتاب. It is not based on the wishful thinking of you, your wishful thinking, or the wishful thinking of the people of the book. Us here, Allah is addressing us. لأن في بعض المسلمين الآن, he goes and he commits adultery, and he steals, and he lies, and he deals in riba, and he kills. Why are you doing this? يا أخي حرام يا شيخ. يا أخي إن الله غفور رحيم. غفور رحيم. طب ما هو إن نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. ما هو ذا الإيه؟ في فئة, في طائفة خرجت عن الملة بالإرجاء, سموه المرجئة. يقول لك ما دام بتقول لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله أنت زي جبريل. إيمانك زي جبريل. As long as you say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, you're like جبريل. والناس دول أثبتوا, those people actually they said فرعون is a Muslim. فرعون حيروح الجنة. يقول لك فرعون حيروح الجنة, ربنا حكم عليه في القرآن حيروح النار. يقول لك ما هو قال لا إله إلا الله بتوع الإرجاء دول. He does not pray 5 times. He does not fast. He does not observe the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you call upon him, لما بتصليش يا أخي, لما بتزكيش, يقول لك إن الله غفور رحيم. ربنا غفور يا أخي, إيه المشكلة؟ أنت حتى ما تهدي الأمور شوية يا شيخ. هكذا. فليس بأمانيكم, it is not based on the your wishful thinking, ولا أماني أهل الكتاب. أهل الكتاب عملوا إيه برضو؟ What did the people of the book do? قالوا إيه؟ عيسى was placed in the cross for my sins. خلاص, do as you please. Wishful thinking. ليس بأمانيكم ولا أماني أهل الكتاب. Here it is. من يعمل سوءا يجز به ولا يجد له من دون الله وليا ولا نصيرا. If you commit evil, you will be held accountable for it. And you will find no protection, no place to hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of resurrection. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٍ فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ نَقِيرًا. And whoever does righteous deeds while he is believer, while he say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, he will go to Jannah. This is the rule of the game. This is the overall rule of the game. Now you're coming 2,000 years from Adam all the way until Isa, and you're changing this? لا. There is something wrong. There is something wrong. ويا إخوة والله أنا أحكي لكم نبي الله عيسى يقول يعني إن صح عنه يعني وهذا تفسير قول الله تعالى ومصدقا لما بين يديه من التوراة. Think not that I came to abolish the law, but I came to fulfill it. Isn't that what he said? He said something like that. I did not came to abolish the law. He actually says this. They narrate. This is in their gospel. Whosoever obeys the least command of Allah and command others to fulfill it and obey it, he will be called في ملكوت السماء عظيمة. He will be elevated in the kingdom of God. من عمل عملا صالحا هذا هو وأمر غيره دعي في ملكوت السماء عظيمة. And whoever disobeys the least command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and commands others to disobey, دعي في ملكوت السماء حقيرا. هذا قول. فهو laws, commands. Now you're coming in the middle and saying all you have to do is believe that Isa died in the cross for your sins. لا لا. ولذلك يا إخوة يعني من ضمن when رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that Isa is coming back, one of the things that he will do, a lot of Muslims, they read the text and they don't understand the depth of it, and he will kill the swine. Swine is more like khinzir, huh? The pork. He will kill the pork. What does it mean? I have never changed this. Simply, I have not. I never told the Christians that eating that salami that they have in IHOP, huh, in the morning is halal. عمره ما كان حلال الخنزير للنصارى. Never was made lawful. And that's one of the things that he will do. So this is number one. Number two, listen to this carefully now. Number two, proving that concept, the concept of crucifixion, it's hard to prove. Because the textual evidence from Genesis, اللي هو سفر التكوين, all the way to العهد الجديد, كله بيتحدث, all of it is about salvation in you, obeying Allah and staying away from the haram. Require them to misinterpret text, and they came up with something called the original sin. اللي هي الخطيئة الأصلية بنسميها. What is the original sin? That we are born into this world sinners already. يعني ابنك الصغير ده اللي بيطلع من بطن امه who comes out of the womb of the mother, sinner. اهو. وان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كل مولود يولد على الفطر. ما هو الموضوع برضو, you need to understand the issue has implications that contradict our religion. That's why you need to understand it. They introduced the concept of the original sin, اللي هي الخطيئة الأصلية. يقول لك everyone is born already a sinner. He already inherited the sin of his father Adam. Adam and his wife Hawa, when they ate from the tree, all the children who are born into this world, they must be sinners, and they must basically it's called baptized, something like that, in order to come out of this. Oh, طب هذا كلام في ديننا. Do we agree to this? Absolutely not. We don't have this in our religion. كل مولود يولد على الفطرة. This goes against an important principle in our religion, which is ألا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى. طب بالله عليك, if I come to Americans right now, to the Americans who came from Europe, and I tell, you know what? I decided to board a court and I want to bring you to judgment because of killing all the Indians when you arrive to America. The Americans who are living, this happened 300 years back. What they're going to say to you? You want to bring people to justice for the sin of their ancestors? The kalam, it doesn't even make sense for them. This is also established in the gospel. They have text in the gospel that reads this. شوف سبحان الله أفرأيت الذي تولى وأعطى قليلا وأكدى أعنده علم الغيب فهو يرى. شوف أم لم ينبأ بما في صحف موسى وإبراهيم الذي وفى ألا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى. Have they not been told about what is written in the law, the Mosaic law of Musa, and also the law of Ibrahim, that no one is held accountable for the sin of another person? In order for them to justify this, they came up with the original sin, which we do not believe. We believe that yes, Nabiullah Adam, Asa Rabba, Prophet Adam disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He ate from the tree. We believe this. But we believe also, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually taught Adam certain words with which he can seek repentance, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repentance. وَالْكَلِمَاتِ ذُكِرَتْ فِي سُورَةِ الْأَعْرَافِ قَالَ رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Allah, we have wronged ourselves. And you find them also, ya ikhwa, seeking a justification in the events of slaughtering. You find a Christian always bringing this out to you. Didn't Ibrahim sacrificed? الذبح الذبح التنسك أو النسك أو is one of the acts of worship basically that we have. It's just another act of worship. قل إن صلاتي ونسكي. When you slay, it does not mean that you want to. They bring up the event of the slaughtering of Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam. Of course, they say Ishaq. This can be refuted easily. And they bring out other, the slaughtering in the Old Testament. And they say, you see, it has been always like this that you have to slaughter. لا. الذبح كفارة. When we commit a sin, for example, Allah tells you, feed 60 masakeen. Feed 60 masakeen. The ideal way is to slaughter and feed the masakeen. This is an act of worship. It does not mean, it does not justify this. So this is one, two, three. And I tell you this, listen to this carefully now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse, they killed him not, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُ. They killed him not, they crucified him not, but it was made to look like this for them. The Quran, by the way, reads that they crucified someone. The Quran tells that there was somebody who was put in the cross, but not Isa. Listen to this. And how can sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a literate man, 600 years later, comes and make that statement? وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ إِذَا الْأَرْثَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. Comes and says, وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ لَفِي شَكٍ مِنْهِ. And those who differed upon this, they are full of doubts. They do not have concrete knowledge. And again, I'm addressing Muslims. I know you believe that it never took place. But if you read the gospel, you will find out that from their gospel, that Prophet Isa was not put to the cross. Using textual evidence from Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. First of all, I need... Maybe an average Muslim doesn't know this. You know, the Gospel of Mark is the earliest Gospel which was written. You know how many years after that event? 40 years. And by the way, it used to be said in the past, and this changed, the gospel according to Mark. That is not the speech of Mark. Yani Mark did not say this. Matthew did not say this. John, Luke did not say this. No, as if Mark narrated it and somebody heard it and then he wrote it. طب احنا عندنا في ديننا, look at our religion, الحديث. If you don't bring me that chain, امشي. اهو. Go. Chain of narration يعني. According to Mark. Who heard it from Mark? Who? We don't know. So the earliest collection of this event was written 40 years. But of course, the Gospels of Paul is earlier, 15 years after that event. But who is Paul? Paul, by the way, is the one who came up with all this scenario, with all this formula. Who is Paul? Paul used to be a Jewish rabbi who was in the business of killing anyone who accepted Isa. He never met Isa in his life. He never met Isa. And by the way, I go back to the disciples. The disciples were not there. They were not there when this event took place. None of them was except John. That's, if it is correct. For Paul is the one who came up with this formula. The first one, what is his story, Asidi? He tells you, I was walking into, towards Damascus. كنت مسافر ناحية دمشق عشان أقتل شوية نصارى هناك, to kill some Christians there. And by all the sudden, I saw a light. And then someone spoke to me from behind this light, told me, أنا عيسى, I'm عيسى, and you are the bearer of my gospel now, and I was crucified in the cross for the sins of humanity. Spread this. طب الله عليك ده كلام. اه. ده أنت هذا, يعني الكلام هذا. يا إخوة, this subject is so important. That's yours, if you believe this concept, يا إخوة, الله سبحانه وتعالى, like I said earlier, made لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله crystal clear. Why? Because our salvation in this world. Now, you're giving me a theory. You're telling me about an event, hearsay, and you're telling me that my salvation in this? I'm sorry. I have to back off. I have to look into this. I have to reflect upon this. Because this is my salvation. Meaning if I go wrong with this, that means I'm a dweller of the hellfire. You want to tell me someone who was not even there is the one who introduced the whole concept? طب انت يعني, in order for you to simply claim that you're a prophet delivering a message, you must have an ayah, you must have an evidence. You must have a miraculous thing. Paul did not have anything. He basically said this and was accepted by the Roman Empire. They promoted it and so forth. Shuf, listen to this now. Listen to this. Subhanallah, this confirms what's in the Quran. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Quran? وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ, they killed him not. وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ, they crucified him not. وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ, but it was made to look like this for them. وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ لَفِي شَكٍ مِّنْ, and those who differed upon the issue, they do not have concrete information. Hear this. مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ إِلَّا اتِّبَاعَ الظَّنِّ. Isn't that what the Quran says? They have no knowledge of this. They did not see it. They only follow theories, conjunctures, guesses. We think this is what happened. And we think this is what happened. وَمَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ إِلَّا اتِّبَاعَ الظَّنِّ وما قتلوه يقينا. They killed him not. What happened to him, يا الله؟ بل رفعه الله إليه. الله سبحانه وتعالى raised him to himself. وفي آية يا إخوة كثير من العرب يعني the Arab speaking brothers they misunderstand it. لأن العجمة دخلت في ألسنتنا. لو قول الله تعالى وإذ قال الله يا عيسى إني متوفيك. العربي لأن العجمة. You know that we don't speak Arabic now. We speak artificial عربي. بقى ومش بقى ومرسي ومش عارف إيه عربي إيه ملخبط. أهو يقول لك إني متوفيك. The word توفى in the minds of a lot of Arabs it means died. يقول لك you know فلان you know this person and this person توفى. توفى meaning he died. لا انظر إلى لسان العرب لابن منظور رحمه الله توفى أي استرد الشيء كله. توفى يعني توفيت الساعة I given you the watch completely. متوفيك here body and soul. In some Arab they will say the Arabic speaking brother they will say meaning he was killed and then Allah raised him. لا لا متوفيك I'm taking you back to me body and soul ورافعك إلي I'm bringing you back to me. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يعني quickly إن شاء الله the last point and إن شاء الله tonight between مغرب and عشاء myself and Sheikh Mutahir Sabri will be here and hopefully addressing the subject and taking questions. So if you want and you want to bring, ya ikhwa, this subject is so important that you teach it to your children. Muslim children now, they go and get eggs and put eggs in the thing and they color the eggs. ومش عارف كلام يعني كلام جاهلية أولى. كلام ما ينفعش. انت لك دين, لك عقيدة. You have a creed, you have عقيدة. الكلام, all of this is related to this matter. ها؟ في مصر حدانا حبوا يخدانوا قالوا شم النسيم, شم النسيم. Smell the spring. But see, هذا كله is related. Tonight, inshallah, bring your children. Hopefully, will answer questions about this subject. Hopefully, على عجالة quickly because I see that brothers is so crowded in the back. Here it is. We believe that Sayyidina Isa is coming back as Muslims. نحن نؤمن بعودة المسيح. So if we submit to the fact that he was crucified. خلاص لأنك if you die in this dunya you cannot come back to the dunya you can't. أفما نحن بميتين إلا موتتنا الأولى. You taste death here خلاص it's over you don't come back to this dunya you don't. Alright so if we believe that he died that is why the Christians by the way when they spoke about Prophet Isa coming back في كتاب الرؤى in their book of Revelation they mixed it up with the day of resurrection. They say he's going to come back in the day of resurrection. يوم القيامة الناس هيقوموا وهو هيقضي بين الناس وهيقيم العدل من أورشليم. لا we believe this will happen before the day of resurrection. As Muslims نحن نؤمن بعودة المسيح قبل الساعة بل هو من علامات الساعة من علامات الكبرى للساعة. He is one of the major signs of the day of resurrection. يعني قراءة هذه الآية في سورة الزخرف وإنه لعلم للساعة. انظر كيف قرأها الآخرون وهي قراءة ثابتة صحيحة وإنه لعلم للساعة. He is a flag of the hour. Of course, some of the Muslims, they say, طب يا أخي, how can someone go up there and live up there? يا أخي, ثبت في دينك أن نبيك, أن نبيك صعد إلى السماء. أنت بتؤمنش بالمعراج. You don't believe in the ascension of your messenger. رسول الله went up to the heavens, the seven heavens. Yeah, the duration of time is not the same, but the theory is proven. It can happen. And Allah is able to do everything. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, كيف أنتم وإمامكم فيكم؟ الحديث في مسلم. جابر بن عبد الله is the narrator. How will you be when your imam is amongst you? The imam of the Muslims in the Masjid al-Aqsa is about to lead the salah. Nabiullah Isa will enter the masjid and will say, come to lead. Ya Rawhallah, he will say, no, I'm not here to lead. He will pray behind the imam of the Muslims. That means he's not bringing any other religion. He is here to fulfill some of the work which was already delivered to him in the sunnah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he spoke about his return, he will say, he will do the following. Number one, يقتل الدجال, he will kill the Antichrist. يكسر الصليب, he will destroy the cross. He will basically say, who told you that somebody died for your sins here? This is bogus. ده كلام ايه ده. ويقتل الخنزير, that means the laws. Let's go back, Christians, let's go back to the origin, the law. Obey Allah, stay away from the sins. And he will take care of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. ويرفع الجزية, يعني no religion but Islam. Gog and Magog is two tribes, I don't want to get there. He will, because of the virtue of his dua, Allah will cleanse earth from them. But he will also rule earth from Jerusalem according to the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh, the Sharia اللي هم خايفين منها, سيدنا عيسى will come and apply it. And that is why when laws, divine laws are implemented, there is barakah in earth. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, wal hadith fi Musnad Ahmad, and I love this hadith wallah, fi Diya al-Maqdisi والإمام الديلمي, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, طوبى لعيش بعد المسيح, طوبى لعيش بعد المسيح, طوبى لعيش بعد المسيح. What a life it will be when المسيح comes back. لو أنك بذرت حبك على الصفا لنبت. If you throw seeds on rock, it will grow. وهذا موجود في كتبهم. It's actually in their books. But again, they mixed it with the day of resurrection. The boy will play with the snake, and the wolf will play with the sheep. موجود. البركة ستحل في الأرض. He actually wished, صلى الله عليه وسلم, النبي, والحديث في مسند أحمد, سنده صحيح, حديث أبي هريرة, I wish I can live to meet المسيح. And he delivered a message to us that we must deliver to our children. He said to us, if I am not to live until I see him, please make sure that if you meet him, convey my salam to him. Are you going to teach your children this, brothers? Are you going to teach them this? Come on. Wake up, brothers, wake up. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا.